thought is mind, and the emotion or consciousness as heart. They will describe like this.
So when Bhagavan says that when the mind sinks into the heart, he will use a phrase like that. He says, yeah, when the mind sinks into the heart, the I consciousness, the I will dissolve and the real self will shine. Phrases like that he will use often. He uses often. When he says sinks into the heart, you mean he's talking about consciousness when he says heart in that way.
Shall we go to the other topic? Is the discussion later to the meditation is over?
No, one last question. Yes, we have put 20 years or 30 years of practices to explore various paths, and you are saying to drop it all, or drop it all, for our mind, again thinking how to drop it. Mm-hmm. You've done so many things with so much of hard effort, and you're asking everything to drop it. Mm-hmm. Our mind doesn't agree with that. What do
you mean? Better you can try for 40 years. as a struggle for 40 years, you may also. Because you may join hands with me, and you may also try for 40 years.
Sometimes it may look like I may not get it in this life. I will need to continue the next life. Suppose if there is a, if I have not met you. So the question is like, what do we do with the meditation, what we have learned? It's the question is like, it may be helpful to everyone.
So here, everything is for only preparation, preparatory work. As a entrance, we can do something, we can prepare ourselves. It is good and useful. Everything is useful, and for that you can, but we should not give more importance to that. It will give you liberation, give you enlightenment. Mm-hmm. So you have to be, you have the warning, you have to take this, and you can go on with why you are interested.
Okay, we'll continue with that. Will this meditation, will it help to handle external thing with bring focus in the way that we do the work?
So here, meditation or yoga means to one with the other. We have to union, we have to commune with the other. The communion with the other is the meaning behind meditation. So even though we have no work psychologically, physically the work is there. So when we are attending some work, so you have to work with the work. So the meditation is lifelong, you have to be in the meditation when you are doing some work. So wherever you are having some work, you have to do it with meditation. Then only you can do any work in a proper way. So the doing something in a proper way, in a correct way, that is meditation. That itself is meditation. The life cannot be differentiated from the meditation. Lifelong you can do meditation, but you should not do it for the enlightenment liberation. So the life may be, we can join meditation with our life.
So all jobs in your life, you do with focus or with meditation.
Yeah, yeah. So you are one with that. You put your mind totally in your work, that itself is meditation.
Since our search for the enlightenment is over.
Yes.
So we do meditation in our work, but it has, but not for freedom.
Not for freedom. So the next topic we are going to have is thought and thinking. What is thought and what is thinking? And for one time, there is one government servant. He is a government employee. Once there was a meeting in his office, some higher officer is conducting a meeting, and this employee is a participant. At the middle of the meeting, the employee's phone, cell phone is ringing. And immediately he switched off the cell phone. But even though he behaved like this, he was accused of, and he was charged of attending the meeting without switch off the cell phone. And he was, as a punishment to this thing, he was transferred to a punishment area. You know, he was given an order. And the person who is, this is a real matter, real happened thing. And the person, affected person, he consulted me. So, because the punishment is over, it is not correct. So it is in my part, I have to attend the meeting after switch off the cell phone, but it is my mistake to attend the meeting without put off the cell phone. But at the same time, I have not attended the call. Whenever the call ringing, the next moment I switch off the cell phone, because mistakenly I did. For that, I may be warned. I should not do like this in future. They may want like this and leave the matter just like that. But instead of that, they have given me some unnecessary punishment. So it is not suitable to my grievances. And thinking like this, he has no sleep in his night. In the night, for several nights, he has no sleep. He thinking the same thing is happening throughout the night. So, what we have to do to get away from the problem? So he consulted me. Please give me. Please help me. I am in a position without any sleep. I am repeatedly thinking the same thing again and again. Mm-hmm. And what we have to do in these circumstances? So here we have discussed two things. The one is thought, the another one is thinking. The thought, for example, some unwanted thing happened. So the superior officer punished and he gave him the punishment transfer order. So at once he thinks he is exceeding the limit and he has punished in an unwanted thing like this. And so thinking like this, he has to the same thought again and again. So here, he has the right to get some appeal over the superior officer to cancel this order, or even he can move to the court to set aside the order. He can try. If he want to do some action in the external world, to so make some arrangement in the world, he can think like that. But he is not preferring such kind of action. He accepted the transfer. Even though it is it creates some problem with him, with his, for his life, he accepted the transfer. He has no idea to go upon an appeal or revision or over the order. But at the same time, the thought of the happening repeatedly comes to him. How he can do like this? How can he give this kind of order like this? He repeatedly thinking like that. So, whatever comes without our conscious effort, whatever comes unconsciously, that is known as thought. So, whatever comes without any effort, without our consciousness, it is thought. But whenever we take the thing in our hand and we think that I have to do this, the hair should not be like that, I must be like that. So when we consciously take the thought in our hand and we are doing something with related to the thought, that is known as thinking. So thinking is conscious thought and the thought is the unconscious happening. So when it is unconscious, when it is, there is no necessity in on our part, whatever thought, because thought may come, the next moment it will disappear. No thought will be there forever. So that is the nature of thought. But whenever we convert the thought into thinking, then it will not go. For example, whenever we are standing near the road, before Ramanasrama or anything, we are standing near the road and many vehicles are going here and there. But whenever you enter into a vehicle, the vehicle takes you away. So in this way, the thought may come and go, there is no problem. It will come and go and it will next moment it will disappear. But whenever you enter into the thought, when you make any thought into thinking, then you will be in the vehicle. So it will take you away. So here, the thought is not the problem, the thinking alone is the problem. So if you, the repeated thought may come like this, how dare he is to give me such kind of punishment, the thought may come like this. Let it come. If you give total freedom to the thought, it will, in course of time, it will slow down. But whenever you take the thought in your hand, when you convert the thought into thinking, that it will not go away from you. So here is that, don't make the thought into thinking. You allow the thought, let it be unconscious, don't do it any conscious effort upon that, and it will be all right. So in this way he got relieved from that. So in the same way, some other incident, and it is somewhat serious, more serious. And one family of a doctor, some physician, he is a doctor by profession, and his wife came to me. Their problem is that they have only one boy, one child, and the child died of 1.5 years old. And they got great sorrow about the death of their only child. And the doctor said, anyhow, it is a great sorrow in our family, anyhow I managed, but my wife cannot manage the problem. She is always thinking about the same thing, and we cannot be free from the thought of thinking that. And slowly she got many problems, many psychological problems, many physical problems out of the thinking the same thing. So is there any remedy for that? She also consulted. Here also, I suggest the same thing. What is thought and what is thinking? So for example, if you take the same case, so when the thought that the death of their children, the child, may come to us as thought. So, because it is not created, it comes naturally. So the next moment what we do, we justify the thought. So we are the parents of the child, it is our duty to get sorrow about the death of the child. So we have to be in sorrow, that is good, that is correct. So we take the thought like this. Then we give a conscious approval to our thought. So when we give conscious approval to our thought, then we convert the thought into thinking. So in this way, when we have a conscious approval, that we have converted the thinking, when we convert the thinking like this, it is not going away from us. It is having some repeated work. And whenever a thought we feel like that, we are not trying to free from that. So, but afterwards, in certain moment, we have the same case, we lost the sleep in the night, in the daytime we have some another problem, some heart problem, some pressure goes away, goes up, so many other problem comes. So we are afraid of other things. So here also, when we have the feeling, the same thought, then we think that at any time I may face heart attack, at any time I may become lunatic. So in this way they are thinking like that. So here also, the problem comes in the form of thinking. So the thought may be the cause, the thought may be the reason, it comes naturally. But when it is in the form of thought, it goes away very soon. But whenever we convert the thought into thinking, then we give life to the thought. When we give life to the problem. So, don't create the thought into thinking, you allow the thought as thought, doesn't matter, and you will be all right in course of time. Let it be, in, take its own course, let the thought may come, let the thought may go. But when we give total freedom to thought, for the time being it may be some, it may take, repeated thoughts may come. But in course of time, the occurrence may very minimize, it will become low and low, then sometimes it will be come away from that. And this is the state of what is thought and what is thinking. So if you now you can connect the story of the monkey medicine and how what is the problem in the monkey medicine. So here the prescription is that you should not think about monkey when you take the medicine. But here when the enlightened master came, returned to the king and asked what is the problem. And the king told that whenever I took the medicine, I have the thought of the monkey. And though I cannot take the medicine. He asked the doctor, the master told, now bring the medicine and you take the medicine in front of me and I will look after what is happening. So the king take the medicine in front of the master, and the king took, when the king took the medicine, the thought of monkey came. So he told, so even now itself, the thought of monkey came to me. Then what I do? What can I do? The king told, asked. So here, are you thinking monkey or the thought of monkey happened to you? So the thought of monkey alone happened, I am not thinking the thought of thinking monkey alone came to me. So then how are you responsible for that? So you are not responsible for that, you are not thinking monkey. The thought of monkey may come to you, I am not having the imposition, I am not giving the condition, you should not have any thought about monkey, but the imposition is that you should not think about monkey. So here you are not thinking monkey, the thought happens to you. You are not against the rule, then you may take the medicine. So this is, but the king asked some clarification. So even though I am not thinking monkey, the thought happens within me. So I am responsible for the thought. So the king asked, the master asked him, so there are many organs within you. Your heart is functioning, your lungs are functioning. Are you responsible for the functioning of that? Mm-hmm. Even though it is inside you, but it happens like this, and it takes working on their own. Are you responsible? It is inside you. Whatever is inside you, you take responsibility for that. So in this way, so even though your thought happens to within you, you are not responsible for thought. So you are responsible only for your thinking. So in this way they concluded and you are justified to take medicine in spite of the thought of monkey. So this is the monkey medicine story. And we may have any kind of any other clarification with related to this or this or any subject we are having.